These are the steps of skeletal muscle contraction. The first step is excitation. This happens when the brain stimulates the sarcoplasmic reticulum, releasing calcium. Contraction occurs when troponin attaches to the calcium, allowing the myosin heads to attach to the actin, which causes a power stroke in the contraction. Relaxation phase occurs when the impulse stops and calcium goes back into the sarcoplasmic reticulum. The tropomyosin returns to the actin sites, preventing the myosin heads from cross-bridging and creating another contraction.
Okay. All right, to first understand muscle physiology, we must understand how a muscle fiber is made up. Okay. Thousands of muscle fibers make up a muscle in our body, like via your bicep or your rectus femoris. But what really makes up a muscle fiber, millions of little tiny myofibrils, and I don't know if you can see them, but a bunch of these little fibers that are thread-like and they string out real long, they make up the muscle fiber, or the muscle. And these circles right here are actually called fascicles, and they bunch all the little tiny myofibrils together. And the importance of knowing a myofiber is that a sarcomere is the way we divide each myofiber lengthwise. And these Z lines right here is the border of each sarcomere, and that's how you tell the difference. And what these do in a skeletal muscle contraction is they shorten to contract the muscle, and then they lengthen out or get longer when the muscle relaxes.
Excitation is the first step of skeletal muscle contraction. The brain sends an electrical impulse to the sarcoplasmic reticulum. The sarcoplasmic reticulum is stimulated by the impulse releasing the stored calcium.
This is phase two of muscle skeletal contraction. This is the actual contraction step. So the sliding filament theory is used to explain the skeletal muscle contraction that actually occurs. The actin, which is thin filaments, and myosin, which is the thick filaments, they want to bind together, but they're not able to because troponin is actually covering the actin binding sites. The troponin is a protein that wants to bind with calcium, so in order for that to happen, the sarcoplasmic reticulum has to release the calcium, and the troponin has to connect to it in order for a contraction. And then once that contraction is about to occur, ATP is needed.
What you see right here is the inside of a sarcomere, and we're going to use this to describe how the sliding filament theory works. All right. If you can see, the pink is the myelin, the thick filament, the myelin filament, and their heads are right here. And the actin would be the green lines right here, and their binding sites would be the brown spots right here. And the black is going across will be the protein troponin, because calcium has been yet to been released, and they are covering the actin binding sites because they want to bind with actin, unless calcium is in the picture. And what happens is when your brain sends a nerve impulse it will stimulate your sarcoplasmic reticulum, and it will release calcium throughout. It will release them through the T-tubules, and it will make the troponin bind with it, and it will leave these actin binding sites open. And what happens when that happens, for there to be a connection, we must have ATP, which is the energy source used in muscle contraction.
This is relaxation, phase three of skeletal muscle contraction. Once the contraction occurs, the calcium begins to go back into the sarcoplasmic reticulum, and then as a result of this, the troponin attaches back to the active binding sites to prevent the cross-bridging.